Amelia. I just reunited with somebody that I'd met years ago. Renee Peller is in, and you had contacted us at Winging It.
Yes.
And saying what?
Asked you if you would like to have someone on your show to cook, anything, you know.
Somebody, a regular day person just like me,
right,
who you could teach to cook something simple and easy and fast?
Right, exactly.
What are we cooking today?
Today we are cooking a, I'm making a chimichurri sauce. You marinate it over chicken breast, chicken tenders, and then you grill them on the grill. You can grill them outside or inside on the George Foreman.
Perfect season for grilling, too.
Yes, and I'm making a farro salad, which is an Italian grain. It's like a rice substitute.
Looks so like barley-ish.
Yeah.
Does it have that kind of consistency?
It's wheat, and it's got a lot of protein and fiber in it.
That's great.
So
healthy.
It's called farro.
Farro. I have to remember how to spell that. All right, you know what?
F-A-R-R-O.
Here's an ingredients list. So the things that people are going to need if they want to make this today.
Okay.
Farro.
We're going to make 1 cup of farro with 2 cups of low chicken broth, low sodium chicken broth.
Okay.
And 15 minutes it takes to cook.
Okay, and what
else? We're going to marinate the chicken tenders for 2 hours in the chimichurri sauce.
And you're going to teach us how to make the chimichurri sauce.
And I am going to teach you how to make that. And then we're going to make asparagus wrapped in prosciutto with a... balsamic glaze on top.
That's a beautiful little bottle you have there.
Isn't that cute?
Just briefly explain to us what chimichurri is.
Chimichurri, the original chimichurri is red wine vinegar, fresh basil, fresh parsley, fresh cilantro.
And you have to whip
it
together?
Not necessarily the basil, but I do it my own way. I take the cilantro out, and I put the basil in and lemon juice instead of the red wine vinegar. So it's kind of my own take on it.
It's Renee's take on chimichurri.
And a little lemon juice, yeah.
Excellent. We're going to put the sauce together when we come back in our next segment. Right now, we're going to head back to our web producer, Emily. All right, we are back in the kitchen with our viewer and chef of the day. We're going to call you cook of the day. And she is going to be making a chicken, grilled chicken tenders marinated in chimichurri sauce. I have trouble saying that. Chimichurri. I want to say chimichanga.
I know. It's hard to pronounce sometimes, but...
We're going to get right started with making the chimichurri.
In the blender, we have a cup of basil, a cup of fresh parsley, 2 garlic cloves, 1/3 cup of olive oil, extra virgin olive oil.
Okay, we're going to put that in.
A teaspoon of hot pepper flakes. A 1/2 lemon squeezed.
Mussels.
And just some sea salt and some freshly ground pepper.
Just a tip.
Yep, just a little bit.
Okay, and then I blend it up?
And then we put the top on, blend it up.
She reminded me right when we...
Sometimes it takes a little while to get it to blend.
Okay, high?
Yep, high for just a couple of seconds.
On? What's that?
Sometimes you need a little more liquid, but...
All right, we're going to pretend we did that.
You can add a little water to it if it...
Oh, it just slowly sinks.
Time.
Okay,
yeah.
So you blend that up until it looks like...
Till it looks like...
Almost like a pesto.
Like this.
Look at that. The beauty of
almost
TV.
Almost like a pesto. And then you marinate your chicken tenders in this for a couple hours, and then just put them on the grill. You can obviously do them outside.
The chicken tenders, you can buy them like the chicken tenders, or they just
like
the chicken
breasts? No, just like this.
Okay. And you're going to show us how to do the asparagus wrapped in prosciutto. That looks delicious.
This is just asparagus, and you break off the ends, and just take a piece of prosciutto and wrap it around. Put a little olive oil on, wrap it around, and then just pop them in a hot oven for about 10 minutes.
What temperature?
About 400.
10 minutes, that's it.
That's it. You want them crispy, you don't want them real soft.
All right, terrific. When
and
we come back, we're going to do everything else. We're going to put it all together. A wonderful meal with our viewer right now, with Renee Peller.
Thanks.
All right, here's everything. Okay, I just gave Renee a heart attack. I have Renee Peller here, a viewer who is an excellent cook as well. She's teaching me how to make grilled chicken with chimichurri sauce and some asparagus that is wrapped in prosciutto. And right now, she's just going to do a little side dish with me. And I told her, do I cut it, the tomato this way? And she's like, oh, no. Okay, you told me to core it.
Take the core out.
Okay. We need a knife sharpener and winging it. Okay, so then I just start slicing?
Yes.
Thick, thin?
Like that? Medium.
Yeah. Medium?
Good. We may not need the other one, I'm not sure.
Okay, well, I'm doing this. You tell us what you've done with the chicken.
Okay, what I've done with the chicken is I put it on the George Foreman grill. I've flipped it over now after about 7 minutes. It's about 7 minutes on either side. I like to cook the George Foreman grill open because it doesn't cook it as fast, and sometimes it toughens up what you're cooking. So I always leave the lid on rather than put it down.
How much time do you think you've had them on there for?
About 7 minutes.
Okay, 7 minutes. All right.
So then I've just flipped them over, so we're going to flip them over for another 7 minutes.
And before that, you marinated them in your chimichurri sauce and put it in the refrigerator for about an hour or something?
Yep, an hour or two.
All right, let's talk about this.
So now the farro salad, we have boiled for 15 minutes in low sodium chicken broth.
We've got John here. Let's use him.
And then when it's almost done, you put in about a cup of baby spinach.
I was looking at that.
It just wilts right down, so you don't need to do anything with the spinach.
Okay.
You can put anything in this farro salad.
How long would you take? Say it takes to cook this?
This takes 15 minutes.
All right,
to boil in the pan.
All right, now.
And then you add a little olive oil and a little garlic.
Okay.
And pepper.
Have we done that?
Yes.
Okay. Let's move on to this delicious.
Okay, now what we've made here is the asparagus wrapped in prosciutto. So what I'm going to do now is just put a balsamic glaze on top. It just gives it a real nice flavor.
It's slow, but
it's very good.
It's worth the wait.
It's like a syrup, actually.
How'd you get that to be like that?
You buy it like that.
Oh,
yeah.
So you bought it in that pretty little bottle?
No. I put it in this pretty little bottle. Everything has to look good, you know.
You
eyes.
Are a true chef then. And you come from a big Italian family,
huge
right?
Huge Italian family. My father was one of 10 children.
Oh, my goodness.
And they were 5 sisters, so they were always cooking. Sunday was a big pot of sauce, and one made the brujol, one made the meatballs.
God, I feel like I'm at home. You know, I married into an Italian family. The Buscemi's, and my goodness, that's exactly
fun,
what it's like
though.
With them. Yes.
I would walk around all day with my little pad and paper. And
really?
What did you put in here? How much of this did you put in?
And you utilize that later on?
Yes, absolutely.
Do you just go by instinct now?
I do. Yes.
That's
it's a passion, you know. You have to really love it.
Yes, and I know you do.
I do. I absolutely love it.
Okay, so this is set. That looks beautiful.
Okay.
Now I cut up my tomato. I'm just going to do one.
All right, just do one.
And then
you can, like, put them.
What do I do?
Put, like, one here, one in the middle.
Yeah, oh, like a little kaleidoscope.
Yeah.
Oh, that is prettier. Okay.
Okay, and now put your red onion and your cucumber.
Just sprinkle?
Thinly sliced red onion is good.
Why did they use red onion as opposed to like a Vidalia onion or something?
Know. Well, it's prettier for one.
Oh. Taste is different?
I don't know if the taste is that much different. I just like the way it looks.
Oh, this is beautiful too, the color. I was told the color means a lot in
it does.
Plates.
When it looks good, then you know it's going to taste good.
Not in my case.
Now, gorgonzola. Now, instead of doing like a caprese salad, like you would do with the sliced mozzarella, fresh mozzarella, which to me doesn't have any taste.
I love
it. I do love it, but I'm hooked on this right now.
I love this too. Okay, so what do I do? Crumble it up?
Yeah, just break it up with your fingers.
Okay.
I don't know if you want to use all of it, but.
How about that? Because too much, you know what? There goes the date.
It gives it a great flavor, and it's rich.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
All right, do we have a plate? We've got about a minute left where can you plate it up and show us what the dish is going to look like?
Sure.
Okay. Let's see. I'm kind of tethered here. I need to.
You need to use.
Oh, look at this. Yes, absolutely.
Here's the finished product.
How about that? And how many would you say this serves?
Probably, well, we're going to put the rest of the asparagus on top, on that side. So I would say four.
Absolutely.
Four or four.
I would say four is good, especially with that asparagus and all of that.
And the chimichurri sauce I put on the bottom. I mean, you can drizzle it on top, but I like it on the bottom.
Well, I'd like some extra, too.
You can put some on top, absolutely.
All right, wonderful.
And on top.
With all of this, if you have any leftover, you also have a great second helpings that we're going to do in our next segment.
I do. It's going to be a pasta dish with the leftover chicken and asparagus.
Don't give them any more. That's just a little hint. We want them to stick around. All right, thank you so much, Renee. It looks delicious. I'm going to try it when we come back.
Okay.
All right, Renee is now going to make a delicious second helping with that grilled chicken that she taught us how to make before.
Right.
Let's start right off. What'd you do?
We're going to chop up the leftover chicken. We're going to chop up the leftover asparagus. We're going to add some artichoke hearts quartered, some sun-dried tomatoes, and some grape tomatoes, and a little bit of chicken broth and garlic and a little bit of olive oil.
And then you just put it in together in a pot and you...
Sauté. We're going to sauté a little bit of onion and garlic first and then add the rest of the ingredients. And then we're just going to make some whole wheat pasta, thin spaghetti. Whole wheat pasta is great because it's a little bit firmer. and it's good for you.
Better for you, right?
So after we're done with the sauce, we're just going to pour it right on top of our pasta.
Okay, and how long does it take to actually make
this?
The sauce?
10 minutes.
Oh,
really
that's
fast.
It? We got a heavy pot here. Okay.
Yeah, that is heavy. And then you want to just toss it up with your pasta that you've already cooked for 6 minutes and drained. And then we're just going to put it on our platter.
Okay. I'll hold it up for you. All right, and as you do that,
it's colorful.
It is beautiful. And you put, what is this here?
We're going to put some fresh parsley on top and some grated Romano cheese.
Do you prefer Romano over Parmesan?
Absolutely.
Why is that?
I think it has more flavor, definitely.
Like a cheesy flavor or an aged flavor?
It does. I always use it. That's all I ever use.
What about the mix? Do you like that?
Yeah, I'll use that sometimes, but I always stick to the Romano cheese.
And
it just has a great flavor. It's not real salty.
Do you think replacing anything, if you don't have something like the artichokes, what would be comparable? Like capers or something?
Sure, capers are great.
Look at that.
I love capers.
What a quick dish, other than boiling the pasta.
Very quick. 10 minutes and you're done. Pasta only takes about 6 minutes, so you don't want it real soft.
Healthy and economical, too.
Very.
All right, terrific.
Yes.
Thank you. Renee, thanks so much for contacting us and cooking. I hope we have you back.
I had a ball.
Me too.
Thank
nice
you
to
so
see you
much.
Again. All right. Back to you, Amelia.